How can a student be drunk to school? Now look at this black South African student. As young as this guy is, he went drunk to school. Still, this guy that is drunk now, the parent will not blame him, or the parent will not blame themselves that they did not bring up this child very well. Even the people that are watching this video that are South Africa, they will still blame it on foreigners. They will say it's foreigners that make him get drunk.
I hate foreigners, and the government is doing nothing. Our kids have turned into zombies. It's all because of them.
But I'm wondering why, you know, you said you hate foreigners.
Or they will say it's not a South African person. They will say it's a Zimbabwean person, or they will say it's a Nigerian person, or they will tell you it's an old video. Look at when Nigerian children are busy breaking record home and away.
Good morning, Isabel. Isabel, I admire your bravery to speak about things that matter to you. Always remain courageous. Doshima, so majestic, ever so majestic. Dondo, you have such a calming presence. I feel safe around you. Everyone feels safe around you. How do you do that?
Natural.
It's natural. I like it. Give me that.
Most of them are selling drugs. You can ask my son. He will tell you. He started smoking drugs when he was 14 years old. He said it's crystal. That's him.
Dimakatso is part of Operation Dudula, an anti-migrant campaign group and newly formed political party. They blame foreigners for the poor state of the economy and high levels of crime. Critics of Operation Dudula say they're fueling hatred. Figures show about 6.5% of the country's population are migrants. I joined the group as they went to confront a local shopkeeper who they say is in a dispute with his landlady over rent.
Where's the papers of this business? Bring the papers, put the papers here.
Ama document ukuthi ube la wena wena ama phepha ukuthi usebenze la South Africa now.
You don't have to
tell me passport. Passport issued you vakash. Maqeda melo hamba ubili. Mina
le
attitude
ukuthi
the shopkeeper is forced to sign an agreement giving him 2 months to leave the premises.
This is vigilantism.
This one.
This.
No.
You're not a judge,
yeah.
You're not a policeman, you're not a lawyer,
yeah.
But you just tried to hold a hearing.
Since you intervened, you made sure there's a peace.
Well, you threatened him and you didn't really give him a real option. I was there, I saw it.
You're not vigilant. He is illegally here. If he was not here, you wouldn't never like have this problem.
I've come to meet Annie, who's a campaigner for migrant rights.
Don't worry, I'm not going to show your face.
Yeah. They destroyed all my clothes.
When was this?
On Sunday.
What did they do to the clothes?
They put it in this gutter.
What did they say?
You must go to Nigeria. F*** up. We are the doing that. We are South Africa. I vote in this country. I'm a citizen here. If I'm doing something illegal, fine. Good me. I'm doing illegal thing. Now you make my life miserable. I cannot pay my rent.
The migrants, they are the poorest of the poor. And they are vulnerable. They'd rather go to them and rattle them instead of rattling the cages of the guys living in the glass houses.
Well done. Go have a great week. Mr. Reliable, well done. I mean, it's easy to find people that depend on others. It's hard to find people to rely on. You are Mr. Reliable.
Thank you.
Ever since you became a prefect here. Well done.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Good morning. Abigail. Some teachers make their students better, but some students make their teachers better. I feel like you make your teachers better. That is good. You reduce their work. You make their work easy. Everybody would want to teach you. You're very teachable and a great listener. I admire it. We want to have a great year. This is going to be the best one. You already have high and lofty standards, but you're going to even go beyond that. Have a great day. Chris, what did I tell you yesterday? What did I say about your speech and how you speak?
You said it's nice and
you are such an eloquent speaker. It is incredible. Every time you speak, it's just so like captivating. You captivate an audience. You have that ability.
Good morning, sir.
Incredible. Ma, how are you? Roses are red. Violets are blue. This is Sora Heights, and we're happy to have you. Petals, You don't look so sleepy today. What happened? You're alive. You're well. I feel like you make your parents even...
Wait for your time, yeah. You go, yeah, you go, there, you go, enter. When you got it, oh.
Hi family, welcome back again to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, please go ahead, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so that YouTube will let you know every time I upload new video. If you are returning, you're welcome, welcome, welcome. It's always great to have you here. So this one is gonna be a quick one because my battery is going off. I don't know why I didn't charge it, but anyway, we're gonna be talking about parenting as usual. I understand it's a very sensitive topic, but what makes it a sensitive topic, that's because most of us, we are in denial when we are failing in training our kids, and we just don't want to talk about it. We don't want to hear anything about it. Just leave us alone. That's always the attitude. But today I'm here to share with you that usually when I feel like I'm failing on something, when it has to do with training children, I always go back to my scripture. I always go back into... This is mine. It's very small, this Bible. So I would use Adora's. So she have it highlighted. So I always go back into Proverbs 22 verse 6, which it reads, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. So what that means is that the best way to train up the child is the way to go, which is the biblical way. So train up a child in God's laws. That way the child, you know that you never go wrong, because the Most High is always going to direct you the right direction, and also the Most High is always going to direct me the right direction. I can never go wrong if I follow the Bible. Anyway, I noticed that most of the parents, anyway, when it comes to the South African parents, they are always in denial. If you ask them, why are you dressing your child in a very short miniskirt? They will tell you that, oh, it's my tradition. Zulu culture, you don't know that we don't dress up. Is that a new thing? And then you start to ask yourself, like, are you for real? And then you ask them, why are you letting your child on the street? Oh, you don't know that this is how things are here. This is how we do things. Mind your own business. They are always in denial when it has to do with the children. Anyway, I've noticed that once you want to talk about how they train the kids, how wrong, they are always in denial. They don't want to hear anything about it. That's what I've noticed. So I always like, there's nobody that is perfect, but we are all striving into perfection. So there's really nothing to be embarrassed about if you do something wrong, as long as you realize that you did something wrong. Okay, I didn't train my child well. I didn't do well where I was supposed to do well. And I didn't do the right thing that I was supposed to do. If you can realize that you didn't do it right, and you can be able to correct it because you realize that it's wrong. But most of the South African parents, I've noticed that most of them, they don't even want to hear it. They would actually just tell you that that's the perfect way, and you can't tell them nothing, which I understand anyway, because when the families are run by women, it's always going to be like that. You know, when it's the woman is the head of the home, there's nothing that's going to work. So that's because when I tried to read the stats, I understood that 50% of the population of South Africa, they don't know who their father is. So if 50%, that is alarming. So I just thought to myself that, okay, so that is the problem. So, you know, that is where the problem is. But South Africans, they will not want to agree that that is a problem, because everybody wants to be the boss. Everybody wants to be the leader of their homes. So the fact that you are very comfortable with having no husband, with just having different men, different fathers of the children and everything, you think that is normal, then that is a problem. You know, if somebody can have, which if you live in South Africa, you know that this is like a normal thing in South Africa. where a woman will have 5 children with 5 different fathers, and that will be just a normal thing. Just take the children home. You're not married. Just take them home. That's a normal thing. So you don't see that as a problem. So that alone is a problem. That lady on the video that I did before, she said, the fact that you cannot see the problem, that is a problem. You know, so that is where the problem is, because if you look at most of these children, like how can a child go to school drunk, a boy, and more especially when it has to do with the boys. If the boys, they grow up without their fathers, most of the time they are going to grow up on the street, because you are probably going to be bombarded them with different men in the house. And maybe they get tired of that and they end up going to the street. They will end up growing on the street and they will arrive in school full of alcohol. So, but most people, if you try to talk to them about this, they will all say, oh, it's foreigners. So the video is, I don't expect you to agree with me most of the time. It's okay for you to disagree, but just if you decide to express yourself respectfully in the comment section below. And if you decide to have a chest pain, let your chest pain you, okay, in the comment section respectfully. Okay, I have no problem with that. I don't delete any comments. Sometimes YouTube does delete comments, but I don't. And I do understand that most of the parents, they are even out of their homes. Some people don't go back to their homes. Let's say you have a child that is 10 to 15 years and you don't go home in a week, 1 week, you don't see your child. You don't know what's going on with your child. And you expect that you believe that is okay. And most of the parents, if you talk to them about this, they'll tell you that, oh, mind your business. This is how we do it. Oh, why is your child wearing a miniskirt? Oh, this is a culture. You don't know the Zulu culture? Obviously, that means immediately you start to talk about what the problem. They will tell you it's either, oh, you are maybe because you are a Zimbabwean, or it's because, mind your business. You know, it's always a problem that you are pointing the problem. So the thing is, what I'm trying to say is that just train your kids so that way they don't go out there and be taking powder, because you blaming a foreigner is never gonna work. If Nigerians are to leave South Africa and go back to Nigeria, other group of foreigners will still come into the country and still sell powder to your children. So the fact that this woman, she said, oh, I hate foreigners. How do you hate foreigners when your child, you said it with your own mouth, that your child started taking powder at the age of 14 years. So she started taking powder at the age of 14 years, guys. And then, but this woman, she says, oh, I hate foreigners. How come it's foreigners that giving your child, even your child got hurt because it was trying to steal somewhere electricity when the electricity was off, and then the electricity came back on and your child got hurt because it was trying to steal. So your child was stealing. Was it still because of foreigners? No, it was because of lack of training. Obviously, you are hardly even at home. You're hardly even going to know what your child is doing, because the child started taking powder at age 14. So at age 14 is the foreigners take the powder and put it on the child's mouth. It makes absolutely no sense. I do think that it is about time that parents, they started to take accountability and understand what is the problem and fix the problem. It's all about training your kids, making sure that your kids, they don't go out there and take powder. I always say this all the time on my channel, that it starts from training your children. There's no way you can go out there. I can't go out there and start teaching women when I cannot teach my own children. So you have to start by training your kids before you even go out there and train other women. So I think it's about time we started taking our responsibility as women, because that is something that most South African women, they will not want to hear. I know they are going to bite me on the comment section below, but trust me, I am ready for you, because the truth has to be told. You don't train your kids, your kids will be out there and stealing, and will be out there looting the foreigner shop. You don't train your kids will be out there taking powder, taking the life of other people. You don't train your kids will be out there stealing, and you're still going to be blaming on foreigners. So that is what I wanted to talk about today, that maybe it's about time the South Africans, most, not all, they started training their kids in a better way. And maybe also the fact that 50% of the population, they don't know who their father is, they have no fathers in their home. That is also a problem, because that's the thing that most of the people, they don't even want to hear, is the fact that we have a problem. Let's find out what the problem is. No, you don't want to find out the problem. So that alone, it becomes a problem, like the other video said. So I thought let's just talk about that one. Anyway, I will be back on another video. And for now, I say thank you so much for watching. I will see you again on my next one. Bye.
Honestly, it is very offensive to fight this young girl. And Missy says got no right. And I'm happy that they actually reversed that decision. Because let's face it, when you go to Start SA on their website, you check on how families are structured in South Africa, you'll come to the realization that up to 100% of people living in South Africa, at least 70% are raised by single mothers. Only 30% are living in homes where the father is there and the mother is there. Now, in that 30% that I'm talking about right now, half of it, which is 15% of it, are legally married, raising kids their own. The other 15% are actually cohabiting, what religion call living in sin, raising kids. Those are parenting families. Now, within the very same 30% that is already divided like that, 10% of those actually knows who are their real fathers, and 20% in that 30% is being raised by stepfathers, but at least they are together. Now, when we come back to this 70% of single mothers that are raising kids by themselves in South Africa, the 70%, you've got up to 60% of that, which is the 70%, you actually have 60% of those that actually don't even know who their fathers are. And then you are left with 10% of that 70% that actually knows who their parents, but actually it's just a parent that the mother pointed when Uwakabani. You understand? And funny enough, it because lapo umama wakomba, this person is Wakabani, 5% of those, their fathers accepted them. You see how bad it is statistically? Technically, 50% of the population of South Africa do not know who their father is. So the child that you are fighting, this Vanessa Chidim, she's most likely to be your sister. She's not most likely to be your siblings. If half of the people in South Africa do not know who their parents are, why would you be fighting her? Why?